I want to take some time to address the concern of like, will adaptive training just kind of take me off course with my training plan? So in other words, like, will it keep adapting and just adapt further away from the true north that it was supposed to be on? There are various different questions that we got from people asking that. And to do that, I want to discuss a little bit about how the training plans are built and how adaptive training works together. So each day has a very specific intent and something that should be accomplished, and it's defined. And it basically, when we build the plans, we put up guardrails on those days for adaptive training to work within. It has these constraints that allows it to know, okay, I can select workouts within this range and this range, depending on what this athlete needs. That day should be a day where we're really trying to drive the needle and improve performance, or this is a day where we should not be trying to improve performance and we need to favor recovery, or this is an off day, so absolutely we're not scheduling something on this day. So the plans and adaptive training, they work together really intelligently. Each day has a specific goal to accomplish within that plan, and adaptive training will always work within that framework. So that, combined with your objective data of your performance and the subjective data of your feedback that you give in those surveys, always make sure that it's recalibrating and it makes sure that it's staying on course for you and training you as an individual. So like what that really means is that you're not going to get a workout that because you have an event coming up and it's in 1 week, but you failed one workout. It doesn't mean that it's going to do some huge step change and make you do 1 hour at threshold right before that. If you failed last week at doing 15 minutes at threshold, right? It's going to look at what you need as an athlete, look at the guardrails and adjust. That also means that it's not going to give you a 2 hour workout on a day when you should be only having 30 minute workouts, right? And vice versa as well. So it's all defined and constrained within all of that. It's probably also, this is a good opportunity to bring up one of the criticisms that I saw was somebody said that it feels like adaptive training just makes my workouts easier. And some people say the opposite. They're like, it seems like it makes my workouts harder, but it's super important to remember something that every day should not bring you to the ground. I know that a lot of us are type A athletes that really want to feel like today, because I went completely deep, went all out, like Nate was saying, and I had absolutely nothing left, that was productive, but that's not the case. We need to break that association. Productive changes depending on whatever goal you need to accomplish for that day. And a well-structured plan makes sure that you're doing that sort of variation in terms of what you need to do on those days. So some days it will feel easier. Some days it will feel harder, but it's the right workout you should get.
My response to that is yes. Like it just makes it easier. Yes. Because whatever is going on and how you're answering the surveys and performing it, whatever the default, like we have just like the bell curve middle default, it was not set up correctly for you. So it's a positive. It's like, wow, this AT adaptive training found that this is not for me and it's adjusting it. Either way, those are like, I feel like those should be the people that cheer the most, right? If you go through a system, if you go through the training plan and you never get a single adaptation and you never miss a workout and you move forward, like you've hit the bell. There could be people like this, right? You go through a whole year. You're exactly in the middle of the bell curve. There's no difference. You're like the standard physiological specimen. Nothing ever changes. You never have a break. Those are people should be like, hey, what's up? It's not doing anything. If it's changing a lot, it's there for a reason. And it's a good reason. And you should, I would be like celebrating that rather than complaining about it.
100%. Just because we're used to training and running ourselves into the ground as these type A crazy driven athletes doesn't mean that it's the right thing for us to do. There's some data behind this too that I want to share. So there's been a 94% increase in productive workouts completed since we've launched adaptive training. That's huge, nearly doubled. Like that's then where you want athletes is in that productive range, right? Some days you also want them to be doing achievable ones and some days you want them stretched, but predominantly you're going to be in that productive range.
Let me say it again. Productive means like a stepped increase in that level. So you're not doing these big jumps. You're not going down, but you're just doing that progressive stepped increase, which is, it's like, overload over time with proper rest. That's what we want to see.
It's every coach's dream. They want to dwell within that productive range, right?
You don't burn out.
That's how you get improvement.
You don't get smashed, but you're also challenging yourself and you're like measurably doing more work on these workouts.
Yep.
That's a fact.
Yes. There was a 5% decrease in achievable workouts completed. So in that case, it's probably talking about the workouts. Sometimes when you pick a workout, that's just too easy and not really driving the needle. But then again, 5%, that's not much of a movement, and that's what we want to see, right? Like that's where we want it. There's a 53% decrease in stretch work that's completed. So a stretch, I believe that's a jump of greater than 1.5, maybe?
Yeah, I think it's greater than one.
Greater than
it's
one.
Like 1 to 2. Yeah.
Yep. So in some cases you are prescribed stretch workouts, because that's what the plan has in place. Right. And in some cases you are not prescribed them, but it's good to see that 53% decrease, because when I just self-select workouts, I select stretch and breakthrough. I don't know about you, Nate, but like, that's what I always see. Cause I think, okay, I just need to do the next big thing. And it always ends up driving me down.
Before levels, that's what I would do, because you're like, I want to get to this end result. Let me back it out. And this is, I just have to do, it's like, Pete, I just got to stick it at 400. And that's the way I'll get through this thing, which is not the right way to train. It's like trying to figure out, I need to hit this FTP or this kind of wattage for this minutes. So I'll just fill everything else in. So I'll automatically get there. That's not the way.
For sure. There's a 77% decrease in breakthrough workouts. So those, I think that we're talking a greater than two jump.
Yeah. And it's the idea too, because the actual numbers might change in the future as we get more data, and they might actually be used. That's, if it is beneficial, we'll have these specific for specific people or specific demographics. But the idea is, it's more than a stretch by a lot.
Yep.
And this is a big jump in your level.
And then a 93% decrease in not recommended workouts completed, which, hallelujah, that's good to see.
this is something that we've had people be vocal about on the internet, is they'll say, you know, a trainer was too hard. And I look at their career and they jump from something that's very, maybe they do 10 minutes at threshold and then they jump to an hour, or they do this really hard anaerobic one. And they're like, TrainerRoad is too hard for me. It wasn't in your plan. You just chose that workout. And this is what level's trying to do. So if you bring that workout up, it says, this is not recommended for you. Like, I almost think we should have they should sign something. We send them a DocuSign. Like, I will not hold TrainerRoad responsible for this workout. But honestly too, we should have gave people more feedback, right? We can't expect people to understand this stuff without this system in place. So by doing this, if you do a stretch workout and you don't nail it, that's okay. Like, that is that's expected. If you can't hit a productive workout, well, look at your life, right? What's going on? Like I talked about before, all of these things give you more information in order to do the side. There's always going to be a side of like personal responsibility of, looking at my life, looking at my stress, looking at my nutrition, my motivation inside of this workout. And then that works inside in tandem with adaptive training, so that you can, if you do not feel well, you can, you know, kick it back. Or if you feel awesome, hey, I'm going to actually use workout alternatives and do a stretch today. These workouts haven't been hard enough. I don't like how adaptive training has been pushing me forward. Perfectly reasonable. But if it does happen and you don't complete it, please don't flame us on the internet for doing that, because we did not prescribe that to you.
Well, and a popular complaint too is that TrainerRoad's plans are too hard, and this whole entire system now makes it so that complaint is, I mean, it's an impossibility, right? In the sense that we have every day is planned and intentional, and in how it progresses with such high resolution of workouts to select from, so that it's adjusting for you. It's not trying to adjust you to the plan, right? That's the key. So
that's a good way to put it. Yep.
If you like this video, make sure you give us a thumbs up.
If you didn't like this video, you can give it a thumbs down, but let us know what you would have done differently in the comments below.
If you want to see more of these videos, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you want to become a faster cyclist, check out trainerroad.com.
Do it.